Hi, my name is Jon Bonebrake, and I'm one of the academic advisors in the School of Engineering and Applied Sciences office. You can find your academic advisor by logging in to the Hub Student Center. First, let's talk about the orientation data form. We use this form to make your schedule. So if you don't include AP and recent college transfer credit on it, we do not know about it. We can't take AP scores or college credit from a high school transcript. Your AP scores must be sent via College Board, school code 2925. If you took a college level course in high school, you must send in official transcripts from that college. Contact the registrar's office of that college and have an official transcript sent to Office of Admissions, University of Buffalo, 12 Capon Hall, Buffalo, New York. Here are some common AP articulations, most requiring an AP score of 4 or 5 to equal UB classes. You can see the whole list of AP equivalents by Googling UB AP chart. Click on the link and look for the PDF. Once a schedule is made for you, we send out an email with lots of information in it. If you forgot to include AP and college course information in your orientation data form, there is an option to request a schedule change in that email. Simply click the link in the email and follow the instructions. We don't promise that your request will be approved, but it's good to ask. Now that you know how your schedule is made, let's talk about what a typical first semester looks like. All students have to take the UB seminar. Engineering students take EAS 199 and computer science / engineering students usually take CSE 199. The UB seminar is home base. You'll learn about UB resources and perspectives on engineering and computer science. You'll build relationships with your professor, student leaders, and most importantly, each other. Quick note, Project Lead the Way credit does not substitute this class. Calculus 1 is the starting point for first semester engineering and BS computer science majors. If you're not ready for Calculus 1 yet, we will place you into a pre-calculus class. Now to stay in Math 141, you must take the ALEKS placement exam to assess your readiness for calculus. It's a 30-question web-based test that takes 90 minutes to complete. You need to score a 76 or higher to stay in Calculus 1. You have 3 tries. If you score below, we'll place you into pre-calculus instead. The deadline to complete ALEKS is August 17th, 2020 at 8 a.m. Engineering students also take Chemistry 1 with the lab. You might also see problem solving for general chemistry on your schedule too. This is for students who did not take high school chemistry or who didn't do well in it. Computer science students have a different schedule, which you can see here with Introduction to Computer Science 1. CSE 115 requires Calculus 1, so if you're not ready for Calculus, we'll have an alternative class to replace it on your schedule. Only engineering physics students will see Physics 1 on their first semester schedule. This is a calculus-based introductory physics class. Most other majors take it their second semester at UB. Finally, you might see English writing and rhetoric on your schedule. Here's the chart for English 105 placement. It shows the scores you need to get waived from English 105. If you are waived from English 105, you'll need to pick a pathway to add to your schedule. A pathway is a general education requirement, like an art or a humanities class. Your schedule email will have information on how to select a pathway course. It includes a video tutorial and instructions for registration. More on this in a little bit. Okay, so that was a lot of information. The most important takeaway from this is that you need to watch your email and read it thoroughly when it arrives. It has incredibly important information in it, including your schedule, the link to request changes, and if you have to choose a pathway class, instructions on how to do so. Okay, so let's switch gears and talk about more the UB curriculum and pathways. The UB curriculum is our general education program. Classes like the UB Seminar, English 105, and Pathways. It also includes a capstone course for when you've finished everything. Here's a table breaking it down. You can pause the video if you like. As far as pathways, engineering students choose 4 pathway classes and 2 engineering classes that double dip with your major. Your diversity class and your major requirements in both List 3s double dip as pathway classes. Computer science majors choose 5 pathway classes and typically have 1 computer science class to double dip in the thematic pathways. If you have to add a pathway class to your schedule and need help selecting your pathway classes using the tool, contact your advisor. One last thing, and then I'll review some of our most frequently asked questions. Now that you're going to college, you're going to notice some possibly new expectations when it comes to schoolwork. Your time is now your own. It is up to you to arrange your day and set goals for yourself. Instructors and staff are not going to ask if you're doing your homework or if you're ready for a test. For example, let's say you're taking 15 credits of classes. That's 2 to 3 hours of study per week, per class, resulting in a range of 30 to 45 study hours per week. Think of school as your full-time job. It is important to be organized and make sure you're getting good quality study time for each class. We recommend that you get a planner of some kind or experiment with Google Calendar to keep yourself organized. Never be afraid to ask for help if you are feeling overwhelmed or bogged down. Your friendly seasoned advisor has tips and tricks for staying on top of it all, so make an appointment if you need help. Finally, let's review some facts. What if I need to make changes to my schedule? Change requests must be submitted through our online form. Submit the online schedule change request form no later than Friday, August 7th. Here's the direct link to the schedule change request. Each class in your schedule was recommended by your academic advisor based on a comprehensive review of your academic history and the data you provided on the data form. In most cases, the same exact schedule was given to several other CS students, so that it'll be easier for you to meet and study. So, how can I change my major, and do I have to change my schedule? If you're changing between 2 engineering majors and it isn't computer science, computer engineering, or engineering physics, you will not need to change your first semester schedule. Again, use the online form to request a change in your major. Where can I find a checklist to make sure I am completing all tasks before classes begin? You can use the new student checklist on the orientation website listed here. Okay, so the next video talks about resources and CS that are enormously helpful, including our major flow sheets and the CS portal. Okay, thanks for watching.